Bud Light has just announced that they're going to put nutritional labels on their boxes.
And it's a move that directly targets craft beer. The alcoholic beverage market in America is worth around $350 billion. And craft beer has grown steadily when big-name companies have experienced declining sales.
In 2017, craft beer production volume and sales were both up 5%, while overall beer production was down 1% and sales were down 1.2%. Bud Light has tried to fight back.
Bud Light's for everyone and one autumnal mead.
Is it malty and full-bodied? Because I like it malt.
Recently, craft beer sales have slowed and light beer sales have surged.
Michelob Ultra had the biggest gain for a beer brand in 2017, with sales growing by 23.6% to $1.6 billion. And their selling point? 95 calories. The top three selling beers in 2017 were all light, something that's never happened before.
But Michelob Ultra's success might be an indicator of the way beer drinkers are thinking about their beer.
It's important because it edged out Budweiser, a heavier beer that has been in the top three since 1997. Another factor in the beer market is that as of last year, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration requires chains with 20 or more locations to publish calories in drinks as well as food.
Bud Light is the first company to start placing nutritional labels on their boxes as a result. While other companies might shy away from calorie counts, they're seizing the opportunity.
Bud Light's 110 calories will be listed right next to more caloric craft beers.
While craft beers have been touted as more flavorful, more alcoholic, and just more trendy, they also have more calories than light beers.
Popular craft beer brewery Founders Brewing Company has stouts ranging from 270 to 340 calories. You could have three Bud Lights for the caloric intake of one heavier craft beer.
But craft breweries might have a possible answer to the light beer craze. Golden ales.
It's been called the next big thing for years, since there was a 62% increase in sales in 2015 and a 41% increase in 2017. An example of this is Firestone Walker's 805, with 140 calories. It was originally just a taproom test, but now accounts for the majority of their sales. They made an entirely new website just for this beer because it was marketed to such a wildly different consumer.
Firestone Walker's head of marketing said, "For a lot of folks who are drinking it, they're not craft beer fans. We captured a whole new kind of consumer with it."
The big 110 on Bud Light's nutrition labels might be capitalizing on recent healthy eating and diet trends, but there's also an overall surge in popularity of light beers that might propel it even higher.
Not that Anheuser-Busch has to worry. Over the past 7 years, they've purchased 10 craft breweries, so maybe the craft breweries have it right.
Thanks for watching. Throw us a like. Click subscribe and don't forget to ring the bell for post notifications.